Hey guys, I'm here at Darkly Labs today to show you how to get the results you want out of your diode laser. Before we move on to these five tips, I invite you to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you don't miss any other tips about using maker technology like this at home and in the classroom. When you're in the classroom with a machine like the Emblaser, you want to make sure that your students and yourself get the results that you want. Here's five quick tips that's going to allow you to get the most out of your laser cutter in the classroom. Tip one, the focus. This is really important when it comes to diode lasers. The way the laser is focused is that it's a bit of a hourglass prism, which means that the focal length and where the laser is strongest is in the middle. Always measure your material and be able to put the depth of that material into the software. If there's one thing that I want you to walk away from this video understanding is how critical the focus is. If your focus is crisp, you will get a better result every single time. This is something that I learned through trial and error. So while you might be in a hurry to quickly get that piece of material in and cut out your design, take a quick moment to measure it and put that in the right place of the software. And that will improve your results immensely. Number two, make sure your lens is clean. Because diode lasers don't have the same strength as traditional lasers, the lens is really important. This focuses that hourglass beam we spoke about in tip one and allows you to get the best result out of that laser. On the Emblaser, it's really simple. You just take off the lens and clean it with a lens wipe or some alcohol and then replace it. If you don't have an Emblaser, you may need to look at your machine to work out how to take off the lens, but this is something that I would strongly recommend that you become very familiar with. Why it's so important that you keep your lens clean is that the actual material that you put into the cutter can have an effect on how clean the lens is. If you're using woods that have oils, they will actually collect on the lens itself and kind of create a buffer, making the lens a little bit out of focus, and the results you're getting may not be as optimum as you'd like. You know, this surprised me when I was cutting things like cardboard, paper, or even just laser etching on paint. I found that in a very short period of time, it almost looked like there was a lens on top of the actual lens itself. There was this darker area on the lens. The results I was getting out of that was kind of like a photocopied quality. It wasn't really coming out as sharp as I would have liked it and I've gotten in the past. Once I cleaned that lens, pardon the pun, I got laser accurate images and cuts. On a diode laser, having a clean lens is critical to getting great results. So always make sure that if anything doesn't turn out the way you would like, start looking at cleaning your lens as the first possible solution. My third tip is, if you don't have it, get air assist on your machine. Luckily, the Emblaser machine comes with air assist standard, and what this means is that a stream of air is forced when the laser is actually cutting the material. This actually causes a much cleaner cut, and you don't get any scoring around the actual cut by using the air assist. And it's also a safety issue, because if your material happens to catch a light, the air actually blows it out straight away. A lot of people have asked me, do I use air assist or not when I'm cutting different materials? My answer to them is, always turn on the air assist. If you don't need it, it definitely doesn't hurt. If you have a machine that doesn't have air assist, there are a number of projects on Instructables that talks about how to actually incorporate an air assist system onto a Chinese machine or even a homemade machine. So air assist is a real key to being able to get the results you want on a diode laser. Fourth tip today is all about material, whether it's actually flat or possibly raised up off the surface itself. You might have a piece of material like this that has a slight bow in it. Material that sits around sometimes can absorb moisture and just kind of have a little bit of a warp. One of the things that can actually do is create that focal length issue that we were talking about before. So the middle might be flat, but the sides are actually raised up and cause the laser not to be able to be focused as effectively when it actually cuts it. The other thing that's really interesting, and the guys at Darkly Labs came up with this, these mag clips. These are kind of like little risers that you can clip onto material, and this supports the material, especially if it's bowed, and I'm just attaching this one here. This allows you to actually remove the silicon mats and place the material onto the metal base, because these clips are actually magnetic. That supports the material if there happens to be a bow in the middle, because you can have clips that actually go into the middle to support and raise it up. The other thing that's really great about having a piece of material that's raised off the surface is that it doesn't create any sort of heat buildup or a reflection of the actual laser hitting the material, so you get a much cleaner cut, you don't get any charring, and there's no chance of it actually burning in the machine. So that is my fourth tip when dealing with material that has a slight bow. See if you can raise it up off the surface, and that way you'll get a clean cut almost every time. The last tip here may be a common one, but I'm going to throw it in anyway, and that's keeping your machine clean. We've spoken about keeping your lens clean, but in this case, we're talking about the whole machine. If you keep your machine clean, there's no particles that can interfere with the actual cutting operation, and it's also another safety issue because you don't know what you've cut and what's left in the machine. So there's two areas that I want to talk about right now. One is the actual fan, and on the Emblaser, there's a fan at the top of the actual laser mount. I go in with a little mascara brush and I actually clean out both the fan blades and anything that's in between. I find that keeping my machine clean also helps the longevity of my machine life. So I want to make sure that I get those results every single time. The other thing that I like to do is actually wipe down the internal body of the machine. Now, I know a lot of people who use lasers and they will actually leave the little material around. Using something small like a dustbuster or a handheld vacuum can actually take a lot of those larger particles straight away. And the other thing that I really like doing is taking a wipe and being able to wipe the inside of the machine. And you'll be surprised at how much material comes off on that wipe. This can give you an idea of how the machine actually cuts. It kind of atomizes almost the material into tiny little flecks that you can't see. By wiping down the internal part of the machine as well as the rails, make sure that the machine can work at its optimum. So those are my five tips on being able to improve your results when using a diode laser. I want to thank Darkly Labs for allowing me to come into their office today and be able to take over this space and allow me to present these tips to you. We're really keen on hearing how these tips affected your results when using lasers, so feel free to put any experience you have in the comments below. If you haven't done so before, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so that you don't miss any other tips. And I'm looking forward to being able to share what I've learned exploring my Emblaser machine with you on upcoming videos. Go out there and start creating.